free physics lesson as you pass. This is gravity.
Pardon me?
I said a free physics lesson as you pass. This is how gravity works. It pulls stuff down. This is called attach juggling, the art of three-dimensional orbiting, and this is a three set. It started with the brand Astrojax in like 1987, and it was just like an experiment from a physicist put hex nuts on dental floss, and he learned that these sort of orbits are possible. You can do verticals and horizontals and side to sides.
Cool.
Once you get the third one there, you can juggle it though. So it's like a mixture of a yo-yo and juggling, some clackers, maybe a little poi. With all that stuff mixed together, though, it becomes much more of a dance. I call it a force art. And I figured this out maybe like 11 years ago now. If these two, the ebbs, don't go through this triangle around the flow ball, you can twist it like that, and you can tangle it like this, and it won't become tangled. It'll fall back out again and go back into these active leg orbits. So I've just evolved it into more of like, it's a meditative style, it's a dance, depends on my mood, like to how aggressive or gentle I play, whether I'm flowing or if I'm rhythm. More with the skill of it. Yeah, it's a pretty strange little toy.
Cool, I've never seen one of those.
They sell as Astrojax. The ones I'm playing with here are the name brand. This is their most recent one. It's a componentary system where the body comes separated from the bore and the weight in the middle. So it's all calculated out to be exacting with the weight to help better balance these orbits like this. You can get them pretty small with these because the weight's so isolated in the center. You just learn the control of that it's called like flow control, because you're feeling the flow, and you just learn how to go in and out of not letting it go through that triangle. And so you can like capture it like you would a yo-yo, go back and forth, sort of there's a cat's cradling to it as well, like where you can like grab it and string it up and tangle it back on itself.
Wow.
Pretty weird though. My name is Mike Wise, nice to meet you.
Great.
You look up attach juggling or Astrojax on YouTube, you'll find all these sorts of videos from different players around.
Do they have competitive things? Or?
They never got to that point yet, no. I mean, it got into Walmart and KB and Toys R Us in like 2003, 2005 it was in those stores. And yeah, they didn't have like demo teams or anything, so it sort of lost its steam somewhere in the process of mainstreaming it. It didn't have that competitive teams and events and stuff like that. But I mean, I think they will soon. They're still getting back to that. It's very much a small grassroots thing now because it had its rise and then it sort of evened out a little bit more. The people that are more passionate about it kept going. And I look at it as it's my culture, it's my lifestyle, it's an outlet that I teach to the children and stuff. I work with teens that have disabilities during the daytime. I work at Scottsdale School District, so we're off on spring break this week.
Cool.
So I'm just goofing around closer to my house. But I see it as stemming. They call it when an autistic child spins something or to something to calm. It's sort of like my stemming tool as well. But all knowledge is sort of stemmed. Like
yeah.
It's a student, teacher, master succession. And so I see this very ironically. Like, I mean, this has taught me my philosophy in life. It's like one cause now. It's everything is of the same energy, the same source, light or dark. And then it's your expression of it. It's that knowledge of self that becomes that chaotic mess where you have to figure out how to spin inside the chaos that goes around you. You got to center on your now. So this becomes that platform. This is my soapbox. But I can teach children meditation and something that's enjoying and playful so they don't even realize they're learning all these like spatial recognition and sensory type stuff. It's definitely a platform.
Very
I love the brand Astrojax for making the original. They are the ones that have started this whole idea of an orbiter. Because now there's been other brands, like Monkey Knuckles made a two-ball orbiter. So now most of the sets are loose like this, so you can do two-ball tricks. Or if you just do this is meditation. This is actually called an orbiter, where if that middle ball had lights in it, it would make like a spirographic pattern. So just learn to do this, and that's very meditative right there, just spinning it. Want to try?
Very in. No, I'll try.
This is how easy it is when I hand it to somebody. I sort of show off the position and the technique is how I look at it. You drape it over your finger and close these three so you can pinch it right there. You hitch it with your thumb against your pointer finger. And you have better control of that flow. So it's like a on-off, on-off. There's a light and then there's like a feel. So at some point you're not doing anything. You're just letting it sort of feel that. And then you start catching it with that out-stemming finger. Get the little bar to bend it back on. There's no wrong way to do it. That's the freeing thing about this toy, is it just like interpret it through that movement. I break dance, so that's where it came from for me, and that's why I think I look at it how I do, very chaotic and sort of knowledge of self-based. It's all about moving your core to feel the rhythm, and you get three different orbits to sync. It becomes sort of harmonic, like it's like a... in relating it to music, because I make music as well, it's like having a chord. It's like three notes that are actually combining into one tune. So as you move this, it becomes sort of like visual jazz almost.
Yeah. You sound like a very interesting person.
Oh, thanks, man. Pleasure to meet you. What was your name?
Greg.
Greg?
Yeah.
I go by Mike Wise.
Okay.
I developed a whole philosophy, and just the whole way I look at life has come from playing with a toy, which hard to believe, but I mean, in action, you can sort of see how it could be a possibility that this has been that key to open sort of locked doors in your mind. It's a very transcendental description of it all, but that's how I look at it. That's how it feels to me. Other people interpret it differently. Some people look at more yo-yo, more juggling, and make it more of a toy. They play with it. Like, I just, like, zone out on it, get crazy with it.
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, pleasure to meet you,
Greg. Nice talking to you.
Yeah, excellent. Thank you so much.
Take care.
Have a great day. Good day.